If you're wondering if high fat causes heart disease, man, you have come to the right video. I'm Christy Code Red, author, entrepreneur, retired professional boxer.
And I am Carrie Thompson, MSN, RN, and the Chief Operations Officer here at Code Red.
I created a nutrition program that enables people to lose 10% of their body weight every month without shakes, pills, diet foods, or exercise. We believe in real food, water, and sleep. In this video, we're gonna talk about what made us even start thinking this way about high fat causing heart disease. And then we're gonna go over what the actual real problem is and what's really causing heart disease. So back in the 1950s, there was this man named Ansel Keys, and he came along, he was a researcher, and he was trying to prove that an increase in dietary fat correlated with an increase in heart disease. We had people that were dying from heart disease, and he was trying to find out why. So he conducted this study called the famous Seven Country Study. The problem is, instead of just letting the findings be the findings, he cherry-picked the findings and actually proved his hypothesis when in reality, it was not true. He was also paid off by the sugar industry to blame fat for what basically sugar was doing.
Which completely invalidates all of his results, correct?
Yeah, it really does. There was another man named John Yudkin who was kind of going head-to-head with him, and John Yudkin said, hey, wait a minute, you know, actually, it's sugar that's the problem. And Ansel Keys was dominant and aggressive. And so Ansel Keys stood in front of our government board and convinced them that we needed to lower our fat intake in order to lower heart disease.
And that was based on a fraudulent study. So when you're paid off, obviously, by the sugar industry, nothing you put out is going to be legitimate because of who sponsors you. We base an entire 70 years of nutrition information based on Ansel Keys' incorrect claims. And to me, I gotta tell you, that is really sad. We have blamed fat for what sugar did.
So what happens? What people think that when you eat fat, you eat bacon, you eat avocados, that is clogging your arteries. And it's simply not true. But what is true is when you have high blood sugar, so in the presence of a high A1C or high blood sugar, the LDL particles become sticky, and that's what causes them to clump together, and that's what causes atherosclerosis.
It is like blaming the last bank robber leaving the crime scene. We see LDLs as a marker after people have heart attacks, and so we say, oh my gosh, look, it's all about cholesterol, when actually cholesterol is just the last thing running away from the scene of the crime, and it absolutely does not have to do with cholesterol in the beginning. It is not from eating fat that causes people to have heart disease when they are eating a low sugar diet. You can have fat and it's absolutely safe and it's actually good for you.
Yeah, the problem comes when you combine the fat and the sugar. And I like to say that blaming LDL for atherosclerosis, for clogging of the arteries, the hardening of the arteries, is like blaming the fireman at the scene of a fire. It's just trying to help. So what we see is we see a buildup in an artery, and we find LDL particles there. And so automatically, our society is like, that's it, LDL is the bad cholesterol. We should never name it that. Okay, cholesterol is needed to make every single hormone in the human body. It's not bad.
We've been so brainwashed, and even when I was in nursing school, I was brainwashed to believe bad and good cholesterol. But the truth is that when you eat a sugar diet, it causes inflammation in your body. This is not a controversial statement that I just said. This is actually a pretty known thing. So you're causing sugar, you're causing inflammation. And think of your arteries like pipes. So when that inflammation takes place, you can get a rusted pipe. And when a rusted pipe happens, then your body tries to help. So it sends macrophages, it sends all these helper cells to try to repair it. Well, then those cells die and they leave a layer on that site. Well, then your body goes, ooh, something foreign's going on. So it sends even more stuff to the site. And that is how you start to get blocking of the arteries. That's a very simple explanation.
I like it though. I actually picked
the rusted pipe, and it's caused by not fat, but inflammation and sugar. Sugar causes inflammation. So when you eat inflammatory foods, you're causing your pipes to rust. Your body tries to fix it, and it ends up hurting itself in the end. Sort of like people with autoimmune disorders, you know how their bodies over-respond? It's sort of the same idea. Our bodies are just trying to repair what we've done with inflammation and sugar because we were never meant to eat a high sugar diet. 152 pounds of sugar a year is what the average American eats.
Yeah, and when we say sugar, you might be thinking the sugar bowl that your grandma kept on the middle of the table. No, it's not. It doesn't have to be just sucrose. It could be sugar in the form of Goldfish crackers and Go-Gurts and Ritz crackers and
French bread
and cornflakes. As soon as those pass your mouth, it turns into sugar.
That's how it's processed out. So a lot of people tell me when I talk to them with Code Red, I don't eat sugar. Well, just because you aren't eating sweet tea and sucking on popsicles all day does not mean you're not eating sugar. You absolutely are, but it's coming in hidden forms because sadly enough, sugar is in everything and we have blamed fat for what sugar is doing to our bodies.
So what's your experience with fat and sugar? What have you been brainwashed to believe? I would love for you to comment below. Keep watching, but comment below and tell me what kind of experience you've had. So moving forward, what are some things you can do? Let's look at the five markers of metabolic health. Number one, blood pressure, making sure your blood pressure is under 120 over 80. Number two, triglycerides under 150. Number three, fasting glucose under 100. Number four, A1C under 5.7. And number five, waist circumference under 40 inches for a man and under 33 inches for a woman.
I think it's really important to keep in mind that heart disease is truly a blood sugar problem. So a lot of people that have heart disease, and by the way, heart disease and cardiovascular disease is the number one, one of the number one killers in the United States. You need to say, how are my blood sugars doing? After I'm eating, how high am I getting? How am I able to come back down? If your diabetes or your pre-diabetes, by the way, pre-diabetes is just another way of saying, you're gonna get it if you don't do something about it. So if you are dealing with either of those medical issues, it is time for you to stop eating processed foods and sugar and start eating real food and get these numbers under control. It is so important that you get rid of the fat that's right here around the middle. This puts such a pressure on your organs and it also puts pressure on your endothelium, which is the lining of your arteries. They can't relax. That's why we get high blood pressure. It is so important that you address your blood sugar problems because these things are going to help with your heart disease.
Our dad had a heart attack here a while back, and the first thing he should have done was just get off sugar.
Right, absolutely. It is important to be aware that cardiovascular disease exists. Know your family history. Visit your cardiologist. Keep your blood pressure and your blood sugar under control. But more than that, I would love to encourage every single one of you to join a 10-pound takedown so you can start eating real food, drinking water, and sleeping and getting some education about these topics with us so you can start to make a difference and turn that corner on your cardiovascular health.
And that's what I love about the 10-pound takedown. Right. Every single day, I come live to you at 8 a.m., Carrie and I both do, and we teach you something new. And it is a paradigm shift.
Yes.
We have been brainwashed to believe lies the last 70 years. And slowly but surely, with this grassroots movement of Code Red, we are educating people on the truth. And that's a great place for $47 to get started. Come and spend 30 days with us, lose 10 pounds, and learn the nature of the trap and learn how to avoid it. So click the link below if you're interested. We would love to have you on our next 10-pound takedown. And we'll see you on the next video.